Welcome to H2K Infosys. H2K Infosys is a e-verify business based in Atlanta, Georgia, United States. We provide 100% job-oriented, instructor-led, face-to-face, true live online software training programs. It also includes access to cloud test lab with software tools. We provide live project for you to work on. We also provide assistance with mock interviews, resume preparation and review, and job placement assistance. H2K Infosys is trusted by so many students across the world. H2K Infosys provides world-class services in IT training with real-time project work for corporates and individuals, special IT training for MS students in the United States, software design, development, QA manual and automation, performance testing and maintenance, IT staff augmentation, job placement assistance and tech support.
Web, everything, it is the same, the server is the same.
Yeah, we can find the same location.
Okay.
See, that is there. We can find the same location. Okay.
I have a quick question here. This is Meenal. The application we are discussing, the example we have taken, Bank of America, the application will be in hybrid application, right?
See, that architecture, right, what kind of architecture they use, how I will know, right? Right? Hybrid is nothing but, right, see, while designing the application, right, based on my functionalities, what I will do, I will decide whether to go with native or hybrid. It depends on that architecture of that application, right?
Like in hybrid, we discussed that we'll have some code that will be the platform independent, and here also we are discussing about the web services that will be called over iPhone, Android, that will be platform independent. So I'm kind of confused here.
Go ahead.
That's my confusion. In the hybrid application, we have discussed that we write some code that will be in HTML format, and it will be called by developers, and they will develop native code that will be specific to the platform. And here also, right, we're doing exactly the same. I think we web services will be called, and they will be platform independent, and they will be called by servers. So is there any link between these two, and they are separate things?
Yeah, see, in that case, right, see, based on like whatever we discussed, right, we can say that the Bank of America is hybrid. Again, right, so see, that will be decided by the, like, developer. So here I'm giving you example on this.
Okay.
Fine. So, fine. Now, this is the application which we are going to discuss as part of our basic course, right? So here, right, this is the project which we are going to discuss as part of our basic course. Like, if you go to your Play Store, right there you can download your H2K Infosys application, right? You are having these four pages of this application. First page, second page, third page, and fourth page. So this is the application which we are going to discuss as part of our basic course, right? Fine. Yeah. Now you can ask your questions, right, whatever you have. Yeah, fine. One more thing, like, right, and right, go ahead, please.
Yeah, I just had a question about the advanced course. When are you starting that?
Timelines, I'm not sure. Like, right, you can check with Wongshi or Daniel on that. Like, timelines, I'm not sure.
Okay, and if, you know, like I don't have much experience in automation testing, so is that course for anyone or do you need experience with automation testing before?
Yeah, this mobile, actually, right, mobile automation testing is completely different from normal automation testing. Because mobile automation testing, right, every time we need to do some configuration. If the configuration is good, right, then only things will go proper. So every time, right, we need to install some agents and all. So it will be completely different from your normal automation testing. But yeah, right, you need some programming skills. That always helps you.
Okay, thank you.
Prasad, what language should we know for that? Programming, any language?
Yeah, this is different language, right? Like, if you take any, like, say, for example, CTS is there. CTS is completely different, right? For that, they are using their own language. And if you take Monkey Talk also, they are using their own language. Right? Because, right, I told you, mobile automation testing is completely different from our normal automation testing. It's again, right, if you know one language, again, I don't think the language will be a problem for you.
Prasad?
Yeah.
So the native language is like specific to one mobile, let's say the Android, let's say to the iPhone, the one application that is only for the iPhone.
Right, right. It's OS, not phone, right? You can say that. Android OS.
Like there is one application, MusicTube, that is only for the iPhone, like the Android iOS. And hybrid means it can download the application is for every mobile. Is that
right?
Means?
Right. Yes.
And
yes,
then
yes.
The mobile web application is the same as hybrid, or what's the difference in the hybrid and the mobile? Because mobile web application is same for every mobile.
No. See, mobile web is right, you are opening in your browser.
Okay, let's say in the Safari
Right.
So that
is your mobile web.
Let's say yahoo.com, we are opening using Safari. And
hybrid
or native is specifically to the
language.
iPhone or any LG or Samsung
correct.
Mobile.
Correct.
And in all the cases, the web services are used.
Right.
Either for the mobile web application also, or through the browser, or the specific application also.
See, whenever, right, if you're opening that application through your browser, means it's a web, I mean mobile web. However, right, if you're downloading and from your source and all that, that is what, either it can be native or it can be hybrid.
Yes. So, but in all, both the cases, the web services and the web services are used.
Yes.
So, what's the difference between
web services means, right, you can use in your web applications or you can use in a mobile application wherever you can, right? It's a component only.
Okay.
Right. It's a component of your software.
Okay. And what's the difference between web services and web server?
See, web server is a server, right? Web services means, right, how can I explain it? Like, it's a kind of function, right? It's a kind of functions, I can say.
Okay. Anyway,
don't worry, right? I will talk about that web service, right? I will take one session on web services. Okay,
can you explain again where to use web services? I'm still not able to understand in the mobile application and hybrid and native. Where to use the web services specifically?
Web services, see, when you are implementing your mobile application, means web services is mandatory. See, the thing is, right, what will happen is, if you are using that web services, then it is easy for the mobile web developer. No need to write that functionalities every time on each and every platform. What they can do is, they can use that existing that web services and they will call to their respective platforms.
The web services are used for native and hybrid also.
Yeah.
So for the browser also and the specific application also.
See, web services you can use anywhere. That's what my understanding, right? You can use anywhere. right? Okay. That's a component, right?
Okay.
You can use anywhere.
Okay. Thank you, Prasad.
Yeah.
Prasad, one quick question.
Yeah, tell.
See, web. These web services are used during regular web application testing as well as on mobile web application testing, right?
See, web services we can use in any application. I'm not talking about this application and that application. You can use anywhere.
What I'm saying is, see, suppose I'm in front of my PC and okay. I enter bankofamerica.com. So, okay. So then it uses web services for the login page to present.
See, how will you know that, like, what is that Bank of America architecture? See, just now, right, someone asked that Bank of America, how it will work, right? I take some one, like, I explain with one example, right? So,
okay.
Bank of America means, right, how I will know that architecture and all.
Oh, okay.
See, this is not a web services, right? See, one more thing, right? I wanted to tell you, this is not web services. This is just a mobile applications basic course. Okay, just wanted to tell you. Okay.
But, mobile web application testing, you definitely have to use web services, right?
Right, right. That's my. I mean, that's compulsory.
That's mandatory.
Yeah, I mean, that's what my experience is, that, right? That's a mandate. Yeah, and right, please ask, like, queries with respect to mobile application testing, please.
Okay.
Hi, Mr. Prasad. This is Geeta here. I have a question. Do we use three-tier architecture even for the games, like the game app, like when we are, when the kids are playing the game? How does it work?
Architecture will change. Architecture will change. Right. See here. Right. If I'm using a three-tier architecture, means, right, this is just for example. But sometimes, right, what will happen? Right. I wanted to design my application, right, with some entire architecture. I can do that.
Thank you,
Prasad. In the can you please tell me the explanation difference between simulator and emulator you were mentioning earlier in the
class? Yeah, who will talk about that? We will talk about in the next session, like, what is emulator and what is simulator.
So, Prasad, in this classes, we will be learning to do the testing on mobile application testing, that's in the browser test, like the application in the browser.
Yeah, mobile application testing we will learn here. Yeah.
The mobile browser.
Right, right. We will learn here, like, mobile application testing basic.
Prasad, I have a question. This installation, we should have this installed. The link email that we received at the below, it has the install emulator. Are we supposed to have this by tomorrow's class, or is it something you're going to walk us through?
It will be good, like, if you have that emulator ready, right? It will be good.
Okay, okay. So we'll do that. And also, will you give us assignments to develop test cases? In the class, or
we will write some test cases. See, as part of our course, right, as part of our basic course, right, we will write some test cases.
Okay, thank you.
Hello, Professor.
Yeah.
This is three-tier application, right? A mobile application.
Yeah. I mean, usually we will use three-tier architecture.
Where will you use
the client server
application in mobile?
Client server is a web application, right? You're talking about web application?
Yeah.
Right. This is mobile application, right?
Sorry. Two-tier application. Where we use two-tier application?
Two-tier architecture in mobile, I don't think we will use. I don't think we will use in two-tier architecture. I don't think we will use in the mobile, at least, right? Because in the mobile, right, always this middleware is compulsory. Like, they will use this middleware for maintaining all these web services, right? Compulsory, we have three-tier architecture.
Okay.
Prasad, can we apply for the jobs based on the basic mobile testing?
Yeah, you can do that, right? Mobile application testing, right? I mean, I will give some idea like how to test that application and that. So you can do that.
Today, like 8 years of experience, 7 to 8 years, but I don't have any mobile testing experience.
No. If you're putting, I mean, like 7 to 8 means, right, then they will expect something, right?
But I mean, can we put like different domain and then I switch to mobile like that?
Yeah, right. I mean, mobile, right, if you're putting 1 year and all that, yeah, that's fine.
But in terms of reference, if I'm putting a recent experience of mobile, I would need the references and all, the company name and references and all that as well, right? Just not the project.
That I don't know, like. That projects and all, right? This is not that, I mean, place where we can discuss actually.
Hi, Mr. To share this recording and the PPT.
Yeah, you will get that PPT from Daniel or Wonsu.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, team, then we'll continue with that. Basics of mobile testing tomorrow, and then we will take that application and then we will try to learn what is the strategy of mobile application and all those stuff. Okay, thank you.
This
is H2K Infosys. Okay, yeah, thank you.
So many of our students have given testimonials on how our training programs are. You will find them on kudzu.com and on our website h2kinfosys.com. On our website h2kinfosys.com, you will also find more detailed information on who we are, the courses that we offer, what each course covers. Also, if you're interested in a demo program, please register on our homepage on the left-hand side. Just give us more information about yourself and we will send you a link for a demo class. The demo class is absolutely free. Experience our commitment by just attending an orientation workshop at no cost. Our team of faculty and advisors are here to guide you with the right information. If you still have more questions, please feel free to call us. Call us at 770-777-1269. This is a United States number. If you're calling from the UK, call us at 020-337-17615. You can also email us at training@h2kinfosys.com or h2kinfosys@gmail.com. Thank you for watching our videos. We wish you a great career in information technology.